In the run-up to an election which could be decided in the London constituencies, transport plans to ease chronic congestion in the capital have become key political weapons. And today it was the government's turn to brandish theirs. The Transport Secretary arrived for a conference on European transport, armed with a plan to breathe life back into the railways after years of decline. He announced a big increase in government grants to encourage the transport of freight by rail, and reaffirmed his commitment to breaking BR's monopoly and opening up freight and passenger services to private competition.
The railways are perhaps one of the few areas left in Britain where there is a legal monopoly, where one particular provider, in this case British Rail, has a statutory monopoly. And why should they have? That's really very foolish and unnecessary. So we want to actually allow any responsible person who can provide safe, reliable services, either freight or passengers, to be able to do so.
In road building, Mr. Rifkin told the conference he wanted more private investment and would consider toll schemes to pay for them, while he also revealed the non-stopping Red Route experiment should be extended eventually to other parts of the capital. The Freight Transport Association welcomed the shake-up, but said it wouldn't affect the majority of loads, which are small and travel short distances by road. From the transport pressure groups, there was a mixed reaction.
There's still no coordinated transport policy, particularly for London or for other urban areas. And it seems to us that without that, we're not really going to solve the problems of urban congestion or of pollution from traffic.
In a report this week, one group claims congested London is now in danger of losing its title as the shopping capital of Europe.
More and more retailers will go out of town where it's easier for them to locate. And then London will lose its appeal as a world city.
The Liberal Democrats have dismissed the new proposals as half measures, lacking the government money to back them up. Mr. Rifkin's Labour counterpart, who listened to today's speech, also attacked the concept of private funding.
That ideology is still there, isn't it? It's got to be a privatised railway system. It's got to be private capital. It's got to be subsidies for private companies. Nowhere is a privatised railway found to work.
Whether or not today's initiative proves popular with London's commuting voters, it will at least ensure that transport becomes a vital issue for all the parties in any election campaign. Rob McBride for Thames News.